Okay, we have the MiniWalker here from A4designs. I think they're in Norway or over in Europe somewhere. It's going to be cut on the PS1 laser cutter, so I thought I'd show you guys to it. Show you guys it. I have it hooked up to an RC system right now. Come in a little closer. So you can see the details of the robot here. I have a RC receiver on it right now. Later on, we'll have an adrenal brain. So I'm just testing it with the radio control now. But it's got two mini servos. These are the small type servos. These are XT900 Hextronics. You can order them from online for pretty cheap. They're usually about $7 to $10, depending on where you source them from. You can see that they're actually hot glued right onto the wood here. And then through the servo horn, I don't even have them screwed in, allows you some adjustment. You just pop them onto the servo. The servo horn is glued onto this cross member. You can see the way these parts are assembled. I'm going to post where you can download the vector graphics, which you can modify for different thickness materials, scale up and scale down if you want to use bigger or smaller servos. So let's take a look at how it walks. So I'm using a radio control here that you can see. I'm just going to use these left and right actions to make the robot walk. It's a little hard to synchronize and getting used to it. The Arduino obviously will be able to do this much quicker. So you can see it actually shifts its weight forward at a certain point. That's why the middle of the body is angled. I have hot glue feet on this one, and I hot glued everything together. It's the only glue I used. Even the servos are hot glued in. I'm a big fan of hot glue because I'm impatient. There you go. I think there'd be a way of changing the stroke of the servo so that it would actually turn, too. Right now I have it tethered because I have a large battery pack. I'm going to switch to AAA batteries for the power. It runs off 5 volts, which is convenient because Arduinos run off 5 volts and the servos run off 5 volts. So let's try walking backwards, actually. There we go. So backwards and forward are pretty good. Not sure if the tether's messing it up or... It does seem like you should stroke the servos far enough that it shifts the weight up onto the feet there, it looks like. And then I was thinking of adding some sensors. I bought some sensors too that we could add to the front of the robot to make it back up. Okay, so that's the MiniWalker from A4designs for cutting on the PS1 laser cutter.